Hello student, next point related to the transistor is transistor characteristics. Here is the diagram to study the transistor characteristic in CE mode, means common emitter mode. This emitter terminal is common to the both the input section and the output section. Therefore, this NPN transistor is connected in common emitter mode. Okay, this is the NPN transistor series. Okay, then here is the micro emitter is connected to the base, which measures the current IP, means current flowing through the base. Okay, then this is the VBE. Voltage between the base and emitter is measured by the voltmeter, which is called as VBE. And this VBB, due to this VBB, the base emitter junction is forward biased. In transistor, one junction is always forward biased and another junction is reverse biased. Therefore, base emitter junction is forward biased due to this VBB, and base collector junction is reverse biased due to the VCC. You know what do you mean by the forward bias and the reverse bias. Okay, and in output section we have connected the resistance R. This VCE means voltage between collector and emitter is measured by this voltmeter, and the current IC, the current flowing through the collector, is measured by this micro milliammeter. This is the milliammeter and this is the micro ammeter. Okay. And if we study the input and output characteristic, then nature of graph is like this. First, input characteristics means this section only. The variation of base current, which is in micro ammeter, to the base emitter voltage is called as a input characteristics when collector emitter voltage is constant. VC is kept constant. Okay, this VCEE is kept constant. If it is 10 volt, the nature of graph is like this. Okay, first the current is very low, then it increases. Then the input dynamic resistance is denoted by letter RI. RI is nothing but input dynamic resistance. Okay, and it is the ratio of del VBE to the del IB. This is the ratio of del VBE to the del IB is called as a input dynamic resistance. Del VBE means what? Change in emitter base voltage to the change in base current. And that factor is nothing but of course resistance, and this resistance is the input dynamic resistance. Okay, then in order to study the output characteristic, we have to keep IB is equal to the constant. Therefore, the variation of collector emitter voltage to the collector current is called as output characteristic when IB is kept constant. Okay, then see this. For first case, when the IB is equal to the 10 micro ammeter, then we get the nature of graph is like this. As the voltage VC increases, the current increases, then it becomes the maximum at this point, then it becomes constant. This is called as a saturation current. Again, for 20 microampere, we get this graph. Okay, we get this situation. For 30 micrometer, we get this situation. Okay? Means, as the VCE increases, current increases, then it becomes maximum and it is constant. Then it becomes the constant. Further, we increase the value of VCE, it becomes the constant. Therefore, this is called as a saturation current. Okay, and we get this result from the experiment. And therefore, this is nothing but a input characteristic and output characteristic. And what is the RO? RO means output dynamic resistor is defined as, it is the ratio of del VCE upon del IC. The ratio of del VCE means change in collector emitter voltage to the change in collector current is called as a output dynamic resistance. Therefore, in the case of transistor characteristics, two points are important: input characteristics and input dynamic resistance, output characteristics and output dynamic resistance. Okay. Now, next point is the transistor as an amplifier. This is the one of the most important application of transistor. Transistor can be used as a switch. Transistor can be used as an amplifier. In this topic, we have to use the transistor as an amplifier. Then what is the amplifier? Amplifier is the electrical circuit. If the signal is weak and if we have to increase its strength, then amplifier is used. Therefore, amplifier is an electronic circuit which increases the strength of weak signal is called as an amplifier. Now, here transistor can be used as an amplifier. Amplifier cha role ithe kon karnar ahe? The transistor karnar ahe. Okay, therefore, here is the diagram to study the transistor as an amplifier in common emitter mode. Here is again the emitter is common to this section, it's common to the base also, and it is common to the collector also. This is the one of the property of transistor. Okay, ki input la to ha common asu shakto ani ha sudha input la kay asu shakto common asu shakto. Okay, therefore here is the again the two junctions are used. Okay, three terminals of the transistors are used: base, emitter and the collector. Emitter base junction is always forward bias due to the supply VBB, and collector emitter junction is always reverse bias due to the VCC. Okay, now here is the VI. VI means input signal. Of course, this is the AC signal. It is the function of sine and it is the weak signal. Here is the signal is the weak. This signal is applied to the base of the transistor. Then base current varies. Okay. This base current varies, which produces the large change in the collector current. Therefore, collector current increases. As the current IC increases, the voltage across it also increases. Therefore, we get the amplified output voltage across the output. We get the amplified output voltage. But if the signal is like this, then this is the weak signal input la. This is the output la kaya chala, then it becomes the high as a signal tumhala. The strength kaya chalegi ahe, the increase chalegi ahe. The weak signal cha conversion kasha madhe chalela ahe, strong signal madhe chalela ahe. Jasa speaker apan vapartoy. आवाज जर आपला छोटा असेल तर आपण तिथे माईक वापरतो, स्पीकर वापरतो आणि त्याच्यामुळे आवाज काय होतो आपला मोठा येतो. म्हणजे तिथे सुद्धा काय कशाचं काम असतं, ट्रान्झिस्टरचंच काम असतं आणि तो अँप्लिफायर म्हणून काय करत असतो, तिथं काम करत असतो. म्हणजे सिग्नलची तो काय वाढवतो, स्ट्रेंथ वाढवतो. मग ते सिग्नल इन टर्म्स ऑफ करंट असेल, व्होल्टेज असेल किंवा पॉवर मध्ये असेल. ओके, देअरफोर वी गेट व्ही नॉट इज इक्वल टू द del IC into RL. Okay, therefore V naught is equal to del IC. What is the value of del IC? It is equal to del IB into beta. In terms of the beta, its value is del IB into beta into the RL, where beta is nothing but a current gain factor, and which is greater than the always 50. Then what is the amplifier voltage gain? It is denoted by V naught. It is denoted by the AV. AV for the amplifier voltage gain. Amplifier voltage gain. AV. It is denoted by the AV. Therefore, AV is the, it is the ratio of V naught upon VI. V naught means it is the amplified output voltage to the input voltage, which is the weak input voltage, and that ratio is called as a amplifier voltage gain. Okay, therefore these two points are very important: transistor characteristic and transistor as an amplifier. Okay, weak signal चं conversion कशामध्ये कसं झाले strong signal मध्ये ते महत्त्वाचं आहे की ज्यावेळेस आपण weak signal जे बेसला apply करतो त्याच्यामुळे बेस करंट व्हॅरीज होतोय. जसा बेस करंट व्हॅरीज होईल विच चेंजेस द लार्ज चेंज इन द कलेक्टर करंट. ओके, देअरफॉर कलेक्टर करंट इंक्रीज होतो आणि ॲज द कलेक्टर करंट इंक्रीजेस द व्होल्टेज अक्रॉस इट ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेस. देअरफॉर हियर वी गेट द एम्प्लिफाईड आउटपुट व्होल्टेज. ओके, देअरफॉर दिस चॅप्टर इज ओव्हर सेमीकंडक्टर डिव्हायसेस अँड ऑल्सो द सिलेबस इज ओव्हर. Okay, let us stop here.